Hare Krishna. Better to be crazy in being busy than to be just crazy. Best is to be busy without being crazy. We all sometimes feel that our life is going too fast and we want to slow our pace down. And yes, we all can slow the pace down of our life. But at the same time, it is not just the pace of our life that matters, it is the pace of our mind that matters. And if our mind is in the mode of passion, is driven by lots of worldly desires, with the craving to do things and to get things done and to make an impact, then that mind, if it is not given adequate stimulating engagement, then it will start going crazy and driving us crazy. That means if we don't stay busy, and sometimes you may need to be busy to the point of being crazy. If you are not that busy, then the end result might be that we will simply be crazy. And we see that often we crave, when will I get some free time? But when we get that free time, we might waste it in gossip, we might waste it in oversleeping, we might waste it in random net surfing, social media, and such things. And then we feel, what did I do? So when we don't have anything tangible to do, our mind can drive us crazy. So we need to work with our mind, not for our mind and not against our mind. That means we don't want to just, because the mind is in the mode of passion, doesn't mean we have to constantly be in the mode of passion and stay there. But we need to acknowledge that the mind, if it is fast, it needs us to work at a particular pace. And if we try to act in goodness while the mode is in mind is in passion, no, it will be too much disharmony within us, whereby we will feel as if we are not doing anything worthwhile and we will feel dissatisfied. So we need to direct our selves in knowledge according to the mood of goodness, but then we have to work appropriately in a way that works for our body mind machine. So the purposes and values of our life, we need to contemplate, study scripture, and set in goodness and transcendence. But the pace at which we work will have to be compatible with our body and mind. So broadly speaking, if we can be busy without being crazy, that means calm, absorbed, and purposeful, we could say that is goodness. If we are busy and we are crazily busy, that is largely in the mode of passion. And we are crazy without being busy, that is in the mode of ignorance. So we need to make sure that we want to be in goodness, or at least we want to rise toward goodness. But in goodness and ignorance can both appear similar. In goodness and ignorance, there is reduced activity. In passion, there is heightened activity. If our mind is in passion and we try to decrease our activity, we may well sink into ignorance instead of rising toward goodness. That's why we need to be cautious about how we function. The Bhagavad-Gita describes that everyone is under the three modes of material nature, and we need to work according to our modes, not defying our modes. So Krishna says that actually every one of us, whatever nature we have, we use it in Krishna's service. Sve sve karmanyabhirata samsiddhim labhate naraha Svakarma nirataha siddhim yathavindati tachrunu. So it says sve sve karmanya birataha. According to our nature, in the appropriate work when we engage ourselves, then we can be progressive and attain perfection. And that's why we all need to be regulated. Regulated means we need to function in a way that is regulated for us according to our psychophysical nature. In 6.17, Krishna recommends this regulatedness. Yukta hara viharasya yukta cheshtasya karmasu yukta svapnava bodhasya yogo bhavati dukkha. So when we are regulated in such a way in our eating, in our sleeping, in our recreation, in our work, in such a way that we stay spiritually directed and spiritually connected, then that spiritual connection will gradually raise us beyond the modes and free us from the distress of the material world. Thank you. Hare Krishna.